Hey there, is today your first time here? Or maybe your first time in a while? If so, maybe you're wondering exactly who we are and what this church is all about. Well, we'd like you to know that we're a group of ordinary people who are on an amazing journey together, following Christ. Our guide is the Bible because it's the divinely inspired word of God and it will never take us in the wrong direction. Along the way, we hope you'll see that we are welcoming and spiritually passionate and that getting to know you is a big deal to us. We know that the road is rough sometimes, but we'll work really hard to bring you practical and relevant messages to equip and encourage you through life's ups and downs. We want you to know that we care about this community, and we believe that it's our job to make it a better place. So, no matter who you are or where you've been, we're glad you're here with us today. And we hope that you'll join us on our journey, following Christ and living out His plan for us. So, welcome to church.
To let go of your 2020 in the most awesome way you can do it, and that is in the presence of God. As we await for 2021, one thing is for sure, we're bringing in 2021 in God's presence, and that makes a difference. Amen. And so I want to be very quick today because I believe that this last hour is very precious before the Lord, and I want to speak to you today the word of God that is in Leviticus 6, verse 12 through 13, that speaks like this. The fire on the altar must be kept burning. It must not go out. Every morning the priest is to add firewood and arrange the burnt offerings on the fire and burn the fat of the fellowship offerings on it. The fire must be kept burning on the altar continuously. It must not go out. And today I want to preach this message to you that is about literally having a burning heart. Now, as we come to the end of 2020, can I get a hallelujah? And stand on the threshold of 2021, I think of the words of the saintly Frances Havergal. She was an English hymn writer and a poet that once wrote the most amazing poem. And it speaks like this. Another year is dawning. Dear Father, let it be in working or in waiting another year with Thee. Another year with progress. Another year of praise, another year of proving Thy presence all the days. Another year of mercies, of faithfulness and grace. Another year of gladness, the glory of Thy face. Another year of leaning upon Thy loving breast. Another year of trusting, of quiet, happy rest. Another year of service, of witness for Thy love, another year of training for holier work above. Another year is dawning. Dear Father, let it be on earth or else in heaven, another year for Thee. As another year is dawning, I don't know about you, but as for me, I want this year in which we are going to come into 2021 to be a year that is one richly for the counting of God's eyes. I wanted to be a ear where it is spiritually prosperous and productive. I wanted to be that kind of ear that I will look back in the years to come and view it as one of the best years of my life as far as eternity is concerned. Hallelujah. Now, G.K. Chesterton said that the object of the new year is not that we should have a new year. It is that we should have a new soul, a new nose, a new feet, a new backbone, a new ears, a new eyes. Because unless a man starts afresh about things, he can certainly do nothing effective. The beginning of the new year is a time, in a certain sense, that we can start afresh about things. It should be a time when we aim higher, when we reach further, when we dream bigger and believe stronger. As one day Henry Ward Beecher said, every man should be born again on the first day of January. Start with a fresh page. Take up one more hole in the book if necessary, or let down one according to the circumstances. But on the 1st of January, let every man gird himself once more with his face to the front and take no interest in the things that were and are past. If the coming year is going to be a year of great spiritual advancement and achievement, I believe that there is one thing that is absolutely essential, and I believe that is that we must keep a burning heart. Turn to your neighbor and say, you need to have a burning heart. In Leviticus 6, we read about the fire that burned upon the sacrificial altar. In verse 12, we read that the fire upon the altar shall be burned in it. And note carefully these words, it shall not be put out. The fire shall ever be burning upon the altar. It shall never go out. This was a fire that had been ignited by the Lord himself. When the tabernacle was dedicated to the Lord, he sent fire down from heaven to ignite the altar. And as he ignited the altar, that fire was to be burning day and night. And the priests were to keep the wood on the fire to see that it would never go out. It was the fire that was supposed to never go out. And let me tell you something. Just like the fire on the altar, we must never let the fire in our hearts go out. So you ask, why should we keep the fire in our hearts burning? Well, I want to draw your attention today to three Bible personalities and the effect of burning heart. In these, I want us to see why we must keep a burning heart. So first, we need a burning heart to keep us going. Turn to your neighbor and say, to keep us going. That's right. Now, I want you to turn your Bible with me to Jeremiah 29. And we read like this. Then I said, I will not make mention of him, nor speak any more of his name. But his word was in my heart as a burning fire, shut up in my bones. And I was weary with forbearing, and I could not stay. In simple words, Jeremiah the prophet was saying that he was going to basically quit preaching, that he was ready to get out of the ministry. He was like that one fella from the joke that I heard, that one morning he was late for church and his wife noticed him, that he wasn't out of bed yet. So she went into the room to wake him up, saying, come on now, you got to get up, you're going to miss church. He said, no, I don't want to go, and buried his head under the pillow, just like Isaac does whenever he's wanting to do something. He just buried his head under the pillow. And she said, yes, you have to go to church. So the man replied to his wife, no, I am not going to church. And I'll give you two reasons. First one, nobody likes me. And the second one, you know what? I don't think I like them either. Now the wife put her hands on the hip and snapped back her back. And she said, well, you are going to church, and I'll give you two reasons why you're going to church. Number one, well, you're already 50 years old. I shouldn't be telling you that. And number two, you're the pastor. Who else is going to preach? That was Jeremiah right there. Jeremiah was ready to quit everything, to quit his dream, to quit his ambition. And we have to ask, but why was Jeremiah ready to quit? Notice, first of all, that he was going through a difficult experience. I want you to say a difficult experience. Now, Jeremiah was a fearless and just a faithful preacher of God. And in chapter 19, we read how he entered into the Lord's house and he brought a searing message from God to the people. We read in chapter 20, 1 through 2, that Pashur, the temple guard, had Jeremiah beaten and then put into stocks. Now, Matthew Henry, a Bible theologian and commentator, he states that the word smoke would seem to suggest that Pashur slapped him with his hand or hit him with the staff of authority. And the stocks that he had put Jeremiah in were a very cruel form of punishment. The word stock used in Jeremiah 22 means literally to twist. And it implements that the body was kept in a distorted way. Now there were five holds, one for the head, two for the hands, and two for the feet. And you can see how the body was just kept in a crooked posture that made this form of punishment very discomforting. And as you can see, Jeremiah was going through a difficult experience. So let me tell you something. Now, 2020 was a difficult year for the world. Lots of adaptations, lots of losses, and it took a lot of people by surprise. But one thing is for sure, it left you prepared to face the fact that a new year, especially in these new circumstances in which we're living in, there is literally no guarantee that we will continue to face a difficult experience. I wish I had it within me the power to wave a magic wand over each of you that would place about you a shield that would guard your heart of any distressful, disheartening, or disagreeable, or disconcerting, and disconsolate. However, I don't believe in fairy tales. I believe in Jesus, the Lord, that said, take heart, because in the world you shall go through trials, but don't worry, because I overcame it. Now, the new year may bring things that we never expected or anticipated, actually worse than 2020. And there may be things that will happen that will break our hearts. The very foundation of our life may be washed away by some storm of adversity. And if you are here on the brink, ready to make the transition of 2020 to 2021, oh, how you know and understand that difficulties, circumstances are not out of the realm of possibility. But we also see that Jeremiah was going through not only a difficult experience, but he was also going through a discouraging experience. And it is easy to understand why Jeremiah was so discouraged. Even the strongest Christian would be affected by the things he was going through. There is a saying, good men are but men at their best, was said by Charles Spurgeon. And he also said, discouragement is very natural. It is a native of the soil of manhood. And we see his discouragement in Jeremiah 27. When he says, "Oh Lord, you have deceived me. I was deceived. Though you are stronger than I, you have prevailed. And I am in derision daily. Everyone mock me." Notice a couple of facts about the discouragement of Jeremiah. First, there was a derision he faced. The word derision speaks of being mocked and laughed at. He speaks of how everyone mocked at him, how they mocked him daily. Can you see him in the stocks with the people passing by and making fun of him? I can understand why he was discouraged. But there was also the deception he felt. He says, "Oh Lord, you have deceived me." He struggles with the feelings that God had let him down, that God had promised him protection, and now he's in the stocks. Have you ever felt like this, that God let you down? I doubt that there is anyone in this transmission right here, right now, that had never gone through a moment that you literally wanted to get God and say, "Hey God, come here, sit down on this seat. I'll sit right here and let me teach you how to be God, because you're not doing a good job. You're literally messing up everything in my life." And you probably felt that God had either forsaken you or forgotten you. I know there's someone here. And just as there is the reality that difficulties could be a part of the new year 2021, those difficulties can already bring discouragement in your heart, because you are seeing the news, you are seeing the economic indicators. There may be a dark and depressive days ahead, and the great possibility makes a burning heart an essential need, not toilet paper like we did in 2020. Look, if we're going to keep things going when things get difficult and discouraging, we must have a burning heart. Now, Jeremiah was ready to quit, but he said like this in the book Jeremiah 29, "But his word was in my heart as a burning fire shut up in my bones." He had a heartburn that no tongues or Pepto-Bismol could ever cure. It was the burning heart that kept him going when he was ready to quit. An unknown author once wrote something that is absolutely fabulous. He wrote something like this: "When things are wrong as they sometimes will, when the road you're trudging seems all uphill, when funds are low and debts are high, and you wanted to smile but you just have to sigh, when care is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you dare quit. Life is full of its twists and turns, and as every one of us sometimes learn, and many failures turn about, when he might have won had he stuck it out. Don't give up though the pace seems slow. You may succeed with another blow. Success is failure turned inside out. The silver tint, the clouds of doubt. You can never tell how close you are. It may be near when it seems so far. So stick to the fight when you're the hardest hit, because it's when things seem worse that you must surely never quit." So what will keep us from quitting? A burning heart. A burning heart when things are not going as we wish. A burning heart will keep you going in the difficult and discouraging times of life. That is why we need a burning heart for 2021. Can I get an amen? Hallelujah. Praise be to God. Now, before I move on, let me just point out that the source of Jeremiah's burning heart, it was God's word that was burning in his heart. Oh, there is a poem. It's a beautiful poem. It's a very old poem. And it speaks like this. Oh, how precious is God's words, though the cover is worn and the pages are torn. And though places bear traces of tears, yet more precious than gold is this book worn and old that can shatter and scatter my fears. This old book is my guide. It is a friend by my side. It will lighten and brighten my way, and each promise I find soothes and gladdens the mind. And as I read it, I take heed of each day. To this book I will cling, of its worth I will sing, though great losses and crosses be mine, for I cannot despair, though surrounded by care, while possessing this blessing divine. It's God's word that is the source of a burning heart, that you need to make sure that you are receiving the source daily this upcoming year. I love how my dad Charles has a hard time reading, but that doesn't stop him from getting into the word. No, he wakes up hearing the Bible. He has his app, the Moody Radio app, on his phone. While going to work, he listens to it. And sometimes at night before he goes to sleep, he's right there listening to it all over again. He listens to the Bible app, listening to the Word of God. And let me tell you something. This upcoming year, one thing is for sure. You need to get your Bible, get your pens, get your highlighter. If you're like me, go get yourself some crayon. But it's time for you to eat the holy food, to perceive the holy knowledge, to have the holy thought, and let the holy fire of God burn in your heart. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. And secondly, we not only need a burning heart to keep us going, but also we need to keep us growing. I want you to look to your neighbor and say, it keeps us growing. Hallelujah. And I want you to look with me in Psalms 39, chapter 39, verse 3. And it speaks like this. There we find David, the King David, saying, my heart was hot within me while I was musing the fire burn. You see, Jeremiah not only had a burning heart, but we find that David also had a burning heart. In King David's burning heart, we are reminded that a burning heart keeps us growing. Let me explain you by noticing. He first starts out remembering the covenant. Now, there is a great man, Jonathan Edwards, the great American preacher from the 1700s. Now, he was known for making covenants with God. He referred to them as resolutions. He had about 70 such resolutions that he made when he was the age of 20. And he read them once a week. For example, resolution number 3, it reads something like this. Resolve, if I ever shall fall and grow dull, so as to neglect to keep any part of these resolutions, to repent of all I can remember when I come to myself again. And in a similar way, in a similar fashion, David had made a certain covenant or resolution. In Psalm 39, he is recalling those resolutions. As we read in Psalm 39:1, I said, I will take heed to my ways, that I sin not with my tongue. I will keep my mouth with the bridle while the wicked is before me. David had made a certain resolution. One, he had resolved to take heed to his way. Two, he had resolved to not sin with his tongue. And three, he has resolved to bridle his mouth. Now, the new year is synonymous with resolutions.
And according to the surveys, the number one resolution for Americans in 2020 was to go to the gym and start working out. The number two is to actually save a little bit more money. And number three is to eat healthier. No McDonald's, no Chick-fil-A, no fast food, none of that. Everyone is going healthier. Now, I don't think there's anything wrong with these types of resolutions. But today, I want to motivate you. I want to push you for you to start establishing spiritual resolutions. And I believe a resolution that every Christian should make, or every covenant that they should make with God, is resolution about spiritual things. Let me just give you a short list of spiritual covenants you can make with God. How about that this upcoming year, you set forth that you will read your Bible daily, that you ought truly to make a covenant with God to read every single day His Word. There's also the matter of you praying daily, or you could set up a schedule of fasting. How about attending church faithfully, whether in life group or Sunday service? And if you don't feel comfortable showing up to these, how about you go online and faithfully be there, worshiping God? How about witnessing personally in your family? Are you going to rest while your family member, destiny of eternity, hangs on the line on just a matter of time? Listen, this 2021, it is time for you to preach to your husband, wife, son, daughter, father, mother, brother, sister, uncle, cousin, in-laws. How about you be the instrument of God to bring salvation into your family? Invite them to church. If they don't come, then you invite them to life group at your home. If they don't come, pass by Publix. Buy yourself a good cake. Show up at their house with the cake in your Bible. And you go ahead and witness to them, because you have to do something. You have to witness to your family. You have to witness to your neighbor. How about you know that neighbor that you know that needs God? Everyone has a neighbor in the neighborhood that they know that they need God. You need to go ahead and witness in your job, to your boss, to your manager, to your supervisor, to the employees. Make your job site the target of where the holy move of God is going, man. How about you start to dive, or you persevere in dieting? How about you preach and live what you preach? Hallelujah. Praise be to God. Now, going back to King David, David did not only remember his covenant, as we see, but he also renewed his covenant. David says in Psalms 39:2, I was dumb in silence and held my peace even from God, and my sorrow was stirred. And it would be seen that he had become basically a little relaxed in keeping his covenant. He had made a certain covenant with God, but just like all of us, when we make a little bit of covenant with God, and all of a sudden we see a day pass by, a week pass by, and we go ahead and we push back that covenant to the back of our priorities. And he's saying, but I've been silent. I was dumb with silence and slothful. I held my peace. Now, what brought about the renewal of his covenant? Guess what? It was a burning heart. As he says in verse 3, my heart was hot within me. His heart had been growing cold, but now it was red hot. His burning heart brought a personal revival and a renewal to keep his covenants with God. Whereas his spiritual life had been stale, now he is passionate about living for God. And in verse 2, he was dumb with silence. But in verse 3, he said, then I spoke with my tongue. His burning heart brought about him a renewal in his life. That's why we need to have a burning heart. You know why else we need to have a burning heart? It's because when our heart is hot, it keeps us glowing. Let me tell you something. Spiritual complacency is a sign of spiritual coldness. However, a burning heart keeps us growing. And instead of living a stagnant life, we live one in which we are passionately following after God and the eternal things in this life that are real. And I know that there are some of us here in the transmission that once upon a time in your life, you were very passionate about God. You were living for God. You used to wake up early to pray, to do your devotional, to read your Bible. You used to speak in tongues. You used to be a servant in the house of God. You used to sing. You used to be the first one to show up to church and the last one to leave. And one thing is for sure, you just was so accustomed to living for God, and it was the most important thing in your life. But somewhere along the line in your life, things begin to dominate your life, and the result of that is that you cease to grow and move forward into your Christian life. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. Now, someone has said this. Complacency is a blight that saps energy. Dulls attitude, causes a drain on the brain. The first symptoms is satisfactions with the things as they are. The second is rejection of things as they might be good enough. As good enough becomes today's watchword and tomorrow's standard. Complacency makes people fear the unknown, mistrust the untried, and abhor the new. We need to keep a burning heart to keep us getting complacent. From becoming satisfied with things as they are, rejecting what could be, and accepting the good instead of the excellent or the best. A burning heart will keep us reaching higher, aiming further, seeking more, and going forward. It will keep us growing. And I don't know about you, but as for me, I don't ever want to quit improving or growing. I don't ever want to get to a place in my spiritual life where I keep my silence and hold my peace. No. And if you forgot your covenants with God, oh, how I pray that the Holy Spirit may make your heart burn once more, and He comes and renew your commitments and your resolutions with the Lord in 2021. And you will notice that the source of David's burning heart, he says in verse 3, while I was musing, there was a fire burning. It was the musing, which means to meditate. Then his heart began to burn. Meditation is a match that ignites a fire in the heart. Meditating on God's goodness, grace, and His work, and His word, and the power in the flame will bring us a great spiritual heartburn. Because one thing is for sure, we need it. And if we don't keep a burning heart, we will take lightly to our spiritual resolutions. But on the other hand, a burning heart will keep us growing. Let me give you one more example in the last one, and the final reason why you need to have a burning heart in 2021. Because a burning heart is not only there, it's not only needed to keep us from going and growing, but also a burning heart is also needed to keep us glowing. Turn to your neighbor and say, do you want to glow? Do you want to glow? Do you want to glow? Then it's time for you to have a burning heart. And I want you to look with me in Luke 24 on the accounts of the two Emmaus disciples. And we read on verse 32 that they said to one another, did not our heart burn within us while he talked with us? By the way,
And wow, he opened to us the scriptures. The Emos disciples, like Jeremiah and David,
also
had an experience of a burning heart. The great evangelist Rudy Gimsey Smith was once asked how he was able to be used by God throughout his 70 years of ministry. And his answer was, I never lost the wonder of it all. Tragically, many Christians lose the wonder. As it has been said, that the older we get, the colder we get. And in order to keep us from not losing the wonder, we must have a burning heart. Now the two Emmaus disciples reminded us that a burning heart will keep us glowing. And as you look in the stories, you see that in their story, there were a sadness in their hearts. And as we read in Luke 24, 15 through 17, and it came to pass that while they communed together and reasoned, Jesus himself drew near and went with him. But their eyes were holden that they should not know him. And he said unto them, what men of communication are these that you are having to one another as you walk and you are sad? Jesus joined them in their walk. And although at the first glance he did not reveal himself to them, one thing is immediately noticeable is that they were with sadness in their face. That the glow in their face was gloom. And you ask, why were they sad? Well, Jesus just had been crucified. And his crucifixion and death had been a major blow to their hopes, dreams, and visions. And these hopes and dreams are expressed in verse 21. But we trusted that had been he which should have redeemed Israel. They thought that Jesus was the Messiah that would deliver them from the Roman rule and bondage of that present moment. But his death had thrown basically a cold water on such dreams. And it was Vince Havner that said that they were right in their chronology and in their theology, but they had no doxology. That the fire that had gone out in their heart, the fire was just gone. And if we're not careful, the things that happen in our life can be just like a wet blanket, smothering out the dreams and aspirations and goals. It was A.B. Simpson that said, our God has a boundless resources. The only limit is in us, our asking, our thinking, our praying are too small. Our expectations are too limited. And in some cases, the problem is not that our expectations are too limited, but that a certain thing in life has been stuck in our heart as a dagger to make our dreams cease to exist. And sometimes we are like, as I recall, a famous occasion that happened in a football game, and I believe it was the state of Michigan, that there was a kicker, and it was a few minutes left in the game, and his coach just sent him in there, and he went in to kick, and the minute that he kicked the ball, 2 seconds away from ending the game, he kicked the ball, but instead of looking to the ball, he looked to the referees, and his coach noticed that. And once he returned to the sideline, his coach said, hey boy, good job. Let me ask you something. I noticed that you didn't watch the ball after you kicked. What happened? And he said, coach, don't get mad at me, but I had to look at the referee instead of the poles to see if I hit it because I forgot my contact lenses. And I couldn't see the goalpost. And we're sometimes like that. We lose sight of our goals and dreams, just like these two disciples. Their hopes and their dreams had been shattered. But however, a burning heart can breathe new life into our dreams. We're not only just as it did for them. We not only see that a saddened heart, but also we see that later on that the burning heart brought gladness to their faces. As we read in verse 27, and beginning at Moses and all the prophets, he, meaning Jesus, expounded unto them in all the scriptures the things concerning himself. Jesus took on them a journey through the scripture, showing himself in all the types, foreshadows, and figure. And as he talked and walked with them, the fire started burning in their hearts again. Their hopelessness turned into hopefulness. Their consternation turned into expectation. Their desperation changed into inspiration. And the gloomy faces turned into a glowing faces. So you ask, why do we need to have a burning heart for 2021? Well, we need a burning heart to keep us going. For what will keep us not quitting is a burning heart. We need a burning heart to keep us growing, because it will keep us from becoming stale and stagnant in our spiritual walk. And we need a burning heart to keep us glowing, because it will keep us dreaming, believing, striving, and reaching. And the source of their burning heart was spending time with Jesus. It is very important that we spend time with the Lord. Just like Martha, we must not get so busy that we do not sit at the feet of Jesus like Mary. Work will never be a substitute for worship. Spending time with Jesus is the secret of having a burning heart. So, do you want to keep going? Do you want to keep growing? Do you want to keep glowing? If so, keep a burning heart and let the words of the hymn of the writer Edwin Hatch be your prayer for 2021. As he wrote, breathe on me, O breath of God, till I am wholly thine, until this earthly part of me glows with thy fire divine. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, I pray that you will never let the fire go out on the altar of your heart in 2021. Hallelujah. Amen, Church of God. Praise be to God. God bless your life. And right now, we're going to go into a moment where we have about 18 minutes left into the year. And we're going to go into the presence of the Lord Jesus and the Heavenly Father and the Holy Spirit and prayers. Now, we're here, won't be able to kneel down because the cameras will not see us. But if you're at home, listen, now is the time for you to go ahead and just forget about your phone. You're going to be able to tell all your friends later, your family members, Happy New Year. Tell your kids to go ahead and respect this moment and teach them how to go out of a year and bring it in the new year. Now, Isaac is asleep, but if he was not, he would be here with us. But I ask you, kneel down, and don't worry about the countdown. I will be doing the countdown for you. And as I do the countdown, the minute we go into the new year, the first thing you ought to do, give the Lord Jesus your heart. Say, Lord, I give to you my heart. To you be the glory, to you be the honor, to you be everything. And then later on, go ahead, give your shout.
blast out your horn. If you have poppers all around your house, if you have poppers wherever you're at watching this, go ahead and pop. If you have fireworks, go ahead and put it out. And then after this, we're going to go into the first blessing of the year that I will bless your life. And by now, as I told each and every single one of you, you should have already with you the anointing oil that we have here specifically at Holy Move Church. But if you're somewhere else and you cannot have, and you do not have a possession of the anointing oil, I ask you to go ahead, get some olive oil wherever you're at. Bless it in the name of the Jesus. And then before I bless you guys, I want you to go ahead and bless you, yourself, your household, and every single one that is celebrating the 2021 with you today. Amen. We have 16 minutes left. Let us go into prayer with the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. As Pastor Sarah to come and join. Yes, Jesus. Praise be to you, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh God, how we worship you. Lord, how we thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, you're so beautiful. I adore you, Lord. I exalt you, God. Jesus, at this moment we're here, Lord. The last 15 minutes, Lord, of 2020. And we're going into 2021, Lord, saying that there is no place I'd rather be. That there is no trip in this world that I would rather be on. If not, Lord, in your presence. At this moment, everyone at home, some in the boat, some watching, wherever they may be, Lord, we ask, Lord, that your presence be with us. And I have nothing but thank you. To thank you, God. I thank you, God, for the amazing blessings and the protection that you have given to me, God, to my wife, to my son, Jesus. I adore you. Sharabakai Toruboko Ramanara. Lord, I don't deserve you. I don't deserve the grace that you have shown upon my life. Oh Jesus, how I adore you. How I adore you, Lord. I want to thank you, Lord, for keeping your promise, Lord, to me, to Sarah. In 2021, you gave us an inheritance. You gave us Renan Isaac, Sakira Marinho, Lord. And Lord, baby that is the joy of a heart given by you to us, Lord, is only here because you kept your promise. As the medicine cannot explain and the medicine declared that he should have never been born, God, that you sustained them in the womb by the supernatural manna. By the supernatural food.
Thank you.
Oh Jesus, I adore you. I adore you, Lord.
I praise you.
I want to thank you, God, for my family. I want to thank you, God, for mom, dad, brothers and sisters, nephews, father-in-law, mother-in-law. That you are making a lot of things new. I want to thank you, Lord, for the provision. I want to thank you, Lord, for the blessings in abundance. Jesus. Lord. Thank you, God. For allowing me, God, to just go ahead and serve you. Jesus, how I love you, God. How I love to serve you. How I love to serve you, Lord. Oh, Lord. Hallelujah. Continue giving him your praise. Continue giving him your worship. We are at right now the last 10 minutes of 2020. Hallelujah. Sharabakai Torobukura Manas. Doro Shokuru Balayas. Thank you, Lord. Praise be to your name, Lord. Praise be to your name, God. Hallelujah. Oh Lord, how I love you, how I adore you, God. You are beautiful, God. Come on, church, 9 minutes left, 9 minutes left. Sharabakai Torumoku Ramanayas. Jesus, I adore you. Thank you, Lord. I want to thank you, God, for my beautiful friends, for my brothers and sisters in Christ, in the Holy Move Church, that this year, Lord, you bless them, and although everything was a wreck this year, you blessed, Lord, all those you entrusted upon my life to take care.
Thank you, Jesus.
I want to thank you for the leadership, Lord, of Holy Move Church. I want to thank you, Lord, each and every single member, Lord, that gave his all, Lord, this year.
Yes.
I want to thank you, Lord, for the lives that you brought into.
Yes, Lord, Jesus.
This family, through baptism, they were made holy. Abby and Michael, oh, Lord, thank you. Jesus, we love you. Jesus, thank you for those that through the preaching of the gospel who whether through online or whether personally, Lord, that you were able to use me to bring them into the Christian life. Thank you, Lord, for allowing me to be an instrument. Lord, thank you, Lord, for the supernatural that you manifested through this spring. Thank you for this supernatural experience that I received, Lord. Lord, thank you for answering my prayers. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for Broward County, Lord. Thank you, God. Oh, thank you, God. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Sharabakai Turubukura Manas. You're a beautiful God. You're a beautiful God. Come on now, church. Keep on going. Keep on praising. Keep in his presence. We're at our five last minutes of the year. Keep on pressing on. Keep on pressing to 2021 in his presence. Sharabakai torobokorabarahas. Yes, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be to you, God. Hallelujah. Shorobokorabarahas. I'm in your presence, God. All I want to say is that I'm not worthy of all your faithfulness and mercy and grace that you have shown upon thy servant. For I crossed this Jordan River with one staff, and now you have made me two camps. 4 minutes left, church, come on. Jesus, thank you for my wife. Thank you for the love of my life. Thank you for, she's my rock gun, she's my target that you put in my life. Oh Lord, thank you for putting Sarah in my life. Thank you. Thank you for working in her, Lord. Each day making her even more holier than she is. Thank you for her intimacy, Lord. Thank you for our caring. Thank you for our love. Thank you for our comprehension. 3 minutes left, church, come home. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. We praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Shurubuko turubuko rabarayas. Praise be to you, God. Come home, church. We're almost there, church. Come home. Last 2 minutes of 2020.
Give it to God. Be in the presence of God. Yes, Jesus, I worship you. I adore you. Praise be to your name. Come on, church. The last minute, we're at the last minute. Come on now, give it your all. We adore you, Jesus. 50 seconds left. Jesus, you're everything, God. You're everything, God. 40 seconds left. Jesus, I don't deserve you. Oh, Jesus. 30 seconds left. I adore you, God. I give you my all. 20 seconds left. Hallelujah. Thank you. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Happy New Year. Thank you, Jesus. Happy New Year, my love. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. Happy New Year to every one of you watching at home. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. Your family. Look who's here to give a happy new year. Yay! I was asleep, Dad, but I woke up. Happy new year! Yay! Hallelujah. Come on in, sweetie. Now, if you're at home, you got the anointing oil. So go ahead and start anointing. Anoint yourself. Anoint your household. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. God is good. God is amazing. This is the most important moment of the year. Now, I know many of you have prepared in your heart to bring before the Lord the first fruit offering that you would give in 2021. But because of the circumstances, I want to personally bless you when you come and bring the first fruit of your offerings to the Lord. So the first fruit will be done on January 10th, if the Lord permit us to do. But now, I want to bless you with what it's called the blessing of the first fruit in your ear of 2021. So put one hand in your heart and the other one do like this, like you're about to receive, because you are surely are. And I tell people that there is a great importance in this spiritual blessing. And let me tell you, this spiritual blessing are for those who honor God, giving Him 2020, the last hour of 2020, and coming in to the few seconds, minutes of 2021. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, Jesus. As your spiritual authority today, I want to bless you before the Lord, because you gave Him and honor Him the first fruit of 2021. I bless you, and may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make His face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord turn His face toward you and give you peace. I bless you to have the overwhelming presence of the Father in your life. I bless you to have the heavenly and spiritual gifts hidden in Christ Jesus for your possession. I bless you to have the wisdom, the guidance, the power, and the fruit of the Holy Spirit. I bless you with abundant joy. I bless you with the spirit of boldness. I bless you with protection. I bless you with productivity. I bless you with prosperity. I bless you with generational wealth. I bless you with land. I bless you with health. I bless you with union among your family. I bless you with peace. I bless you with fidelity. I bless you with hope. I bless you with faith. I bless you with love. I bless you with grace. I bless you with triumph. I bless you with holiness. I bless you with the holy move of God in your spirit, in your soul, in your body, in your relationships, in your family, in your business, in your profession, and in your goals. I bless you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. May the love of the Heavenly Father and the grace of our Lord Jesus and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you in 2021. Be blessed in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Amen, church. From directly from our heart to yours, we love you guys and have a very happy new year. Amen. Woo-hoo!